want to create a new file. Let's go ahead and save it. We'll call it hero service.js. We'll stick it in the server folder. Good. And then let's go ahead and bring in our hero model, which was, there we go. And then I'm going to bring in read preference as well, which comes off of the MongoDB package. So we can say MongoDB and then read preference. Now, the reason why we're bringing in read preference is we're going to actually use that here in a minute to optimize our query. And we'll talk about that when we get there. And then we want to require in our Mongo file, right, which contains our connection function, and then just call connect. And that connects us to the Cosmos DB instance. Now let's create a function which will get all of our heroes out of the database. We'll call it get, and we'll just pass in the request and the response from the route. So instead of handling the request and the response on the route, we're just gonna send them straight through to the service, which is gonna handle them. And the first thing we're gonna do is we're gonna define a new query. So we'll call it dot query, and we'll just say hero.find, and that find is part of that nice Mongoose API. We're not gonna pass in any parameters, so we're just find everything, and read preference nearest. And what this does is it just says simply tells MongoDB read from the nearest database, because Cosmos DB is a globally scaled and replicatable database. This one just finds the nearest instance and reads from it, makes it fast. That's what we want. And then the next thing that we want to do is actually execute this query. So we say dot query dot exec, and that's going to return a promise, which will have our heroes in it, which we can then return as JSON. And say that we're gonna return our heroes. And if we have any errors, we'll catch those. And let's actually tell you what, let's bring this catch down to the next line so it's easier to read. And we'll send an error in. And if we get one of those, then we'll just, first thing we'll do, set our server status to 500, which is a server error. And then we will send back the error. And then I'm gonna format all this so it looks nice and pretty. There we go, that's a lot more readable. Okay, now that we've got this in here, we need to actually be able to call this from our route. So let's go back to our routes file, which is index.js. So let's take all of this out here. We don't need this anymore. And then let's bring in our hero service. And that was from, we're gonna have to go up one level and then hero service. That should be where it's at. And then we should be able to say hero service dot, and there should be a get. And then we're just gonna pass in the request and the response because we're gonna let the service handle that, if you remember. Excellent, okay, so let's start the server. If we don't have any errors, it should fire up, which is excellent. And let's go over to our browser. And if you recall, the server is running on port 3001. So if we come over here and say API/heroes, we should get back an empty array, but we don't. We get an error, and that's because we did not export. So let's go back to our hero service. This is another really simple mistake that I make all the time. I just don't export anything from my modules. So module.exports equals, and then we're just gonna export get for now. And then we'll restart the server, head back over to the browser, give it a refresh. And now we're getting an empty array. So that's coming back. This is as big as you can get in an array in Chrome. But there's no data in there, so that's what we get for now. Cool, so let's define a way for us to put some data in so that we can get it back out. So we'll go back to our hero service and go to hero service. And now we just need to add in a create function. So we'll say create. And again, we'll pass in the request and the response. And then we want to get the ID, the name, and the saying from the body of the post request that's gonna come in. And we can do that just by saying rec.body. Now this is called destructuring. It's new in JavaScript, and it's where JavaScript just looks at rec.body, and if it has an ID, a name, and a saying in it, then it assigns those values into variables called ID, name, and saying. So then we can use them, right? So I can just use the variable name because it now exists because it's been destructured from rec.body. That's called destructuring. It's shorthand. It's easier than us manually mapping things. Okay, so let's create a new hero. And we'll give it the ID, the name, and the saying that came in from the mapping. We'll say hero.save. That's gonna return a promise. And then what we'll do is we'll just send back, we'll say res.json, the new hero. So we're just gonna send back the same thing that was sent to us, kind of like a act, did you get it? Yes, I got it, here it is back. And then we'll do a catch as usual, as per usual with an error. which we will do res.status is 500, and then we'll send back the error as well. There we go. Okay, we're ready to add this to our route, so we can have a route for creating a new hero. So let's go back to our index file, and we'll do router dot, and this is gonna be a post, okay? So it's gonna be a post, and then we're not gonna create multiple heroes, just one, so we'll call the path hero, and then that's gonna give us a rec and a res and a next, the same as the get, and what we'll do is just say hero service, right, dot create, because that was the method that we created, and then we're just gonna pass in rec and res. There we go. And I did make one mistake here. We're not using federos, just functions. Okay. Excellent. There we are. So we've now got a method for creating a hero. Let's go ahead and restart the server and let's see if we can get a hero into our database. And now to do that, we're going to use Postman. Postman is a free tool for testing APIs, and it's pretty fabulous because when you're building APIs, you don't really have a way to test them until you build the user interface portion of your application, which we've done, but we haven't wired that up yet. So we can test our API with Postman. So let's do a new post request, and then we're gonna do 3001/API/hero. And then we need to, in the body, send in the new hero. And I'm gonna send in some raw text here, and we'll do an ID is 0. We'll do the name, which was the tick, and the saying, which was spoon. Somebody needs to tell me why that is the tick saying. Maybe I could just use Google. Okay, let's change this to JSON because that's what Express is going to be expecting us to send in. So that's what we'll send it. And then let's just click send and scroll down and look at our body. And as usual, I did not export the create function. I told you I do that a lot. So let's go back here to our hero service, get and create, save that. Restart the server. Let's try this again in Postman. Send. Okay, and we got back the hero, and notice that it has the ID that we sent in, and it's got a new ID as well, which came from Cosmos DB. So we know that it worked. And just in case we're in question about that, let's go back to our application, refresh over here, and now the API is sending back the tick. And if we go back to our React app, you can see we're still getting the tick. Awesome, okay, so we're connected to Cosmos DB, we can read data and we can create data. And in the next video, what we're gonna do is we're gonna update and delete data and test both of those methods. And then we're gonna tie all of that back to the UI. I'll see you then.